In the Has-Been verse, there are seven rings to hell, each themed after one of the seven deadly sins, and each with their own prince to rule over it. We made a video breaking down everything about the rings as a whole, but today we're going to take a deep dive into the Pride Ring and its king, Lucifer. I'm Deep Cut, welcome back to Cartoon Universe, and before we jump into it, I want to shout out the sponsor of today's video, Squarespace, the perfect platform to build your own website with customizable aesthetic templates for just about any subject. According to the Hell of a Boss Twitter account, the Pride Ring is the top ring of hell, indicating that the rings are all stacked on top of each other, something further cemented by a line from the Hell of a Boss Season 1 trailer where an elevator talks about taking its users to the Lust Ring. Until Hell of a Boss, the Pride Ring was believed by most fans to be the entirety of hell itself. VivziePop has said that Has-Been Hotel will mostly explore the Pride Ring, as that is the only place in hell where Earthborn sinners can exist, seemingly by mystical rule as opposed to regular law. As such, most of the characters from Has-Been Hotel cannot even travel to the other rings, with the exception being characters like Charlie, who were born in hell. Charlie is the daughter of Lilith and Lucifer, with Lilith serving as the Queen of Hell and Lucifer as its king. Lucifer takes inspiration from the biblical figure and is described by VivziePop as being a fallen angel, giving him dominion over demons, and is seemingly the most powerful of the seven princes who rule over the seven rings. Lucifer's outfit has references to apples and snakes, indicating that he may be the snake who tempted Eve into eating the fruit in the Garden of Eden. His outfit is also visually similar to that of a circus ringleader, which fits the circus theme that a lot of hell has, such as how we can see elephants in circus decoration balancing on balls like in a circus, in the background art of the Has-Been Hotel. The theme seems to be that Lucifer is the ringleader of the seven rings of hell, and it is all one big show he is putting on. Sinners are a bit unique as a category. Demons from other rings, such as imps and succubi, all tend to look similar to one another, but sinners' demonic forms are inspired by their life, their sins, and the way in which they died, with many people becoming similar species without necessarily being related the way that imps or succubi are. Names are generally self-assigned by demons, rejecting their earth-given names. However, some demons like Alistair choose to retain them. Every ring of hell seems to have a uniquely colored sky. We have not seen all the rings yet, so we do not know all of them, but the most vibrant we've seen so far is the Pride Ring's hellish red sky. And what little we see of the other skies, there is only typical sky haze and perhaps some clouds, but in the Pride Ring we can see a few celestial bodies. In some shots, we can see a glowing orb with a halo, which fans believe to be the actual physical location of heaven, or perhaps just some sort of portal that can be used by angels, though seemingly not demons. There is also this more hellish-looking sphere, which seems to be something of a moon or a sun, perhaps being what causes the red haze. Hanging much closer to the earth, but still high enough for an entire city to spring up under it, is of course the mysterious pentagram of Pentagram City. We do not know what this pentagram is, or even if the people of hell know what it is, but the territory beneath it is one that sees frequent turf wars for demons like Serpentius or Cherry, who want to be seen as overlords. Pentagram City is the capital of the Pride Ring, but the Pride Ring is a large place with many different locations. Many are just as advanced as Pentagram City, but many places cater to large masses of sinners from particular times and places in Earth's history. They tend to band together to create their own society, similar to the one they experienced in life. There is one such area called the Cannibal Colony, which is meant to look more like the 1940s, and anyone who does not actively try to fit in with the styles and culture are ganged up on by the other demons, who slaughter and then eat them. We can see this happening in the prequel comic following a day in the life of Alistair, as it's a place he really enjoys. While laws do seem to exist in hell as a whole, they tend to be to benefit those who are already in power, so there is very little in place to actually help the Earthborn sinners. Outside of the societies that exist, there is also natural wildlife, most of which is demonic and dangerous. One location, called Wonderland, is described as being a place of impossibly horrific flora and fauna, a place where the worst parts of evil energy have been absorbed by the surrounding. We've got more to cover on the Pride Ring, of course, but real quick, I just wanted to say thank you to the sponsor of today's video, Squarespace, the service that helps you design just about any website you have in mind, including shops, fan sites, personal portfolios, or anything else you can imagine. A lot of you watching this are artists like VivziPop, working to get your own comics, stories, and cartoons made, and Squarespace is the perfect place to share them with the world. They even have private community options and video embedding so that you can find new ways to monetize your work and give your fans an experience that just posting on YouTube doesn't. We used our Squarespace site to create hasbeenlore.squarespace.com, a place where me and other fans are cataloging all the information that VivziPop has shared about her shows via live streams. You can make your own site too, and when you're ready to launch, just go to squarespace.com/cartoonuniverse to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain, or just add the coupon code cartoonuniverse at checkout. I'll include all of these links in the description and in a pinned comment down below. Check it out, but don't forget to come back to watch the rest of this video. Another notable location is Imp City, which was established in the 1980s, indicating that there may have been some mass migration of imps from one of the other rings to this location, or perhaps even a mass migration of imps from all over the Pride Ring to create their own community and businesses together. Imps are described as being the lowest of the low, perhaps only outranking hellhounds, so creating a city where they could live among equals might have been a motivation for this. Because this city exists in the Pride Ring, they are able to meet Earthborn sinners, such as the ones that hire imp to kill people on Earth. But the imps are able to travel to other rings whenever they please, which is why so much of Hell of a Boss will explore those other rings. In Hell, the Earthborn sinners are immortal. They can be injured or tortured, but the threat of death from other demons is not one most sinners need to worry about. Because they are so hard to kill, however, Hell has become overpopulated. Though we do not know what this means in terms of resources or lifestyle, angels seem to have taken an interest in the problem. Once a year, a team of angels, known as exorcists or exterminators, come down with special weapons that can permanently injure or kill other demons. This helps keep Hell's population somewhat stagnant. Oftentimes, these weapons are left behind and later sold at the black market, so while you don't have to worry about just any random demon killing you, it is possible for other sinners to have the means to end your existence, but it is rare. Despite being restricted to the Pride Ring, even lower level sinners are discussed as being of higher status in the Pride Ring than natural born demons, like the previously mentioned imps or succubi or hellhounds. Within the society of the sinners themselves, there are other hierarchies as well, with power being held by beings called overlords, who tend to run the major industries in the Pride Ring. Although simply having some sort of power over other demons or even territory is enough to get you the label of overlord. Lord. It is likely that a lot of overlords have access to angels' weapons from the black market, and it is likely part of how they maintain their power. Even Vaggy seems to have one, as the spear she holds looks identical to the ones being collected by demons after the extermination. Above them are, of course, the other deadly princes and noble demons, if they so choose to be in the Pride Ring, and then at the very top is Charlie, her mother Lilith, and the King of Hell himself, and the leader of the seven princes, as discussed before, Lucifer. This is all of the relevant information I was able to dig up on the Pride Ring, but a lot of you know that there are little details and nuances that I may not have addressed, so let us know which ones I missed, and I'll be sure to leave a heart reaction to any cool details in the comments down below. See you next time!